Crochet the last 3 double crochet in the third, chain a slip stitch. There is the slip stitch. I will make a list stitch. I will make a slip stitch. In the previous stitch, I release the chain. I take the chain that I left loose. And there I form one chain, the first, and crochet two more to start row 13. Here I crochet 2 double crochet. There are 3 formed with the chains. Here, the fan unit without a chain. Crochet 1, 2, 3 double crochet of the neck fan with 5 chain. I need 1 more chain, and in the same space crochet the next double crochet. And in the next stitch, 2 double crochet separated, there it is. And we are going to continue each fan. Like that until finish row 13. Here, I am going to close row 13. Here I have 5 chain and a slip stitch in the third chain. There it is finished. I will start row 14. So, do not release the stitch because I had to crochet 2 stitches before. A slip stitch, I turn over the work. A slip stitch and in the next stitch and in the second stitch. I turn over the work on right side and I start with 3 chain. 4 chains, 3 double crochet, and 1 more chain of separation and 1 double crochet. One chain and single crochet in the middle of the fan. One chain after the single crochet. Let's crochet 6 double crochet in this space separated by one chain. I have 3, 4, 5 and the last 6. Here we have only 2. 1 chain and single crochet in the space that we have here. Don't forget the chain. And crochet the same 6 double crochet with a chain of a separation in this space. This is row 14. That is the same as row 16. Let's finish row 14. This is where I close row 14. Crochet 1, 2, 3, 4, double crochet and 1 chain. A slip stitch in the third chain of these 2. That we have here when we start the row and a slip stitch. One space. Here we start row 15 with 2 chains, 2 double crochet without closing. I have 1, 2 and I close with 1 chain. Here I continue with the fan. The next fan will unit here. I will not make a chain separation and we take the space of 1 chain in the middle of 2 double crochet. I have one stitch. Make 3 double crochet without closing. I have 2. I have the third, and here I close it. One chain, we are going to have 2 chains of separation. Continue in each space. The 3 double crochet without closing. I close it, one chain like that. We crochet the fence, and without a chain, when the 2 fan units, it is how. This row, we may here use light row 7. This is row 15. Let's finish it. Here, I am closing row 15. I make the last 2 chains, left R. 4 group of double crochet, and here we have the fixed 1 May. After the 2 chain and slip stitch in the design space that we crochet the stitch. That we close that slip stitch. Here I mark this space. I make 8 chains. I will start the dress in this space. 8 chains, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will use 5 fans. For the sleeves, here I had 2 and 2. And in this one is 5, and I had them marked. Here also 5 fans for these sleeves. Because the same word is being used for that dress. You will have the option now. Let's start the skirt just like we started the neck area. Let's start here in this area. Let's start the skirt. Here we determined how many fans the skirt is going to need. You will see how to increase the skirt. You will have the idea how to increase the size. You will make another row. You may repeat the row also. I recommend it. You can repeat the row for the row 8, from 8 row 8. So you may make another row. One more row more so may make a bigger size. Here I made the 8 chains. In this space, a single crochet. Because I will cut the yarn. The single crochet. And I cut the yarn. I will take the space with this one, crochet 8 chains here, and make the 8 chains, and with that single crochet, I take this space. Slip now the knot. In this space, we cut the yarn. I have made 8 chains. I had the five fans and single crochet. Crochet 3 chains. for the double crochet that we need and two chains of separation we crochet in this area, in this space, I'm sorry, a double crochet, we are going to start the first row of the skirt. Two chains in the third chains. A double crochet, two chains, and in this space where we put the yarn, there a double crochet. There, we have four double crochet. Counting the first three chains, two chains of separation. Like that, we continue two chains the double crochet. Here are the two fans. I take away the mark. Here are the two fans. This is the first one that we are counting this double crochet. These four are the fan that start for this space. Here we have only 1, 2, 2 chains, 3, and 4. Make 4 double crochet in each fan. And 2 chains of separation to start the next first double crochet. Just like we make each fan, these 4 double crochet with 2 chains and 2 chains. And in the 8 chains, let's crochet 4 double crochet, just like this, just like till we finish. In this space, it is the first row of the skirt. Here, I finish the first row. Let's say that this is the row in between two to start the skirt. Now, let's start. The first row, this is how the space will be that we close here of row 16. Of 2 chains, slip stitch in the 3rd chains, and this space for the other slip. Let me extend it. Okay, I will start the first row. Crochet 3 chains, crochet 2 double crochet in the chain space, and 1 in each double crochet. Of the 2 space, 2 double crochet in each space, and 1 in each double crochet. That is how we finish that row. Here, I finish the first row, in total 144. This is row number 1. We will have 18 fans. Here we start row number 2 that we did in the neck area. We start it here, row number 2, and we continue like this until row 15. So you have the instruction till number 15. Here is where we start the skirt, the first of the double crochet. Here, where I had the marked is row number 2. Here is where we have 18 fan. Here we finish the first row. The first row, this is one of double crochet. This is row 9, to start row 9. Row 10, that we have here marked. Row 10, we crochet 3 chains, 2. Single crochet, 3 chains, and 2 single crochet, separated, number 3 chains, and 2 single crochet, crochet together. This is number 10. Here, we need to have 24 fans. This is only in the skirt and in the neck. It is done. When you crochet row 10, which it is this one, left over the 4 double crochet of row 9. Do 4 double crochet on the whole row. You will distribute it in whichever space skipped without crochet. Here we skip 3 stitches and 4 and 1 space. Skip the second, the third, and 4 more advance. Four stitches skip in the different space to have the 24 fans. Here, we arrive at row 16. Here, I finish row 15. Here, we have the blouse, 2 row of the blouse and 2 of the skirt. In the first row of the skirt, we have 18 fans. In the second, we had 24 fans. I close row 15 and we start row 16. Only one slip stitch. This finish row 15. Turn the work only to a slip stitch. A slip stitch, turn the work to the right, crochet 5 chains in row 16 of the skirt, 5 chains. Double crochet, 2 chains, 2 chains of separation. This row is number 8. It has 4 double crochet in each fence. until a slip stitch in the third chain that we have in the first chain space. That you knit is number 16. I close the row under which this number 16. And I start row 17. It just like row 1 and row 9. Let's finish row 17. To double crochet in each chain space and one double crochet in the double crochet underneath. Like that, we finish row 17. Here, I finish row 17. This is how the dress has grown. It is not too it is led yet. It's long because it is extended on the table. Let's start row 18. Row 18 is going to repeat like row 10 and 15. In this third row, we will repeat it. Here, where I have my finger is the third row. Third row has 32 fans. Each motif often is composed of 9 double crochet. Every 9 double crochet you may make 1 fan. And in one group of chains that we have here, and 1 fan with 9 double crochet. This is the third line, and where marked is row 10. Of repetition. By my calculation, leftover will be 8 double crochet. You decided it does 8 double crochet. You'd add a fan or a complete motif for this space to this space. Leftover is 1. You may make it using this 9 double crochet. Leftover. Just count 9 double crochet for each motif. One motif is from the chain to this space. Here. Okay, this mark here is row 10 of repetition. Is where the start of each fan. I have arrived at row 23, the third row of the skirt. We had 32 fans, third, 23, I will make one last line of fans. It will be turn 24 to 31. For row 24 and 31, let's repeat row 8 to 15. This is row 8 to 15. Let's repeat. To have the last row of fans. This is the progress. Let's finish the last row. Just like I explained for the third row before, it is the last turn for. Here you will have 43 fans. You will make it with 9 double crochet. Depending what you have, you will add or skip the stitches. Personally for me, you may add more fan depending on the double crochet you have left over. If 8 are left over, make 1 more fan. Here I finish row 31. I will not add nothing else. You may add any feature you like. I like it like this. Here we have 43 fans in the last row. Here I did single crochet. Here on the die slip, I will leave it just like the scare. Here one slip knot just to start the a single crochet. Under the chain, 3 single crochet in the space. It is 2 chains, so it won't be tight crochet only. 3 single crochet and 1 double crochet in this space of the double crochet. Here I finish only the chain to this space. I close and cut the yarn. Here is the other space and it is finished. Here it is so that I will have more support. Crochet a small E in the neck. The only thing I am doing after single crochet is give 4 space or 4 double crochet. Two double crochet in the same space or 3 chains, and in the same space 2 double crochet. Skip 4 stitches and I do 8 single crochet. Skip 4. Four double crochet. This is to reduce the neck area and give it form. Because it does not give the correct turn that is needed. It all depends on the thick of the yarn. You will see that space that you need depending that you will use. In this space, only a slip knot to a star. A slip stitch and cut the yarn. the other stick will help to tie the two. This is the neck. You may finish with 8 single crochet. Here it is finished. I put one flower for decoration. This is the dress. It is beautiful and fresh. I hope you like it and enjoy. You may crochet in any color and size of your choice. You decide. Thank you and a big hug for all. See you in the next video. Thank you.